Good morning, class. Today we will take up the topic natural resources as part of the subject environmental studies. We will discuss the concept of natural resources and some of the natural resources. So let's begin. A natural resource could be understood as any service or goods that nature has provided to us. So we could understand that it is a bounty that the nature has provided us free of cost. Our nature has provided us with many resources. So broadly, natural resources include the following: forest resources, water resources, mineral resources, energy resources, land resources, and food resources. Now, we will discuss these one by one. So we are starting with forest resources. As you all know, forests are an important natural resource. They occupy about one-third of the world's land area. But however, due to human intervention, the forest cover has been declining continuously over the years. And it has been a concern all over the world. Now, as far as India is concerned, we have approximately 24% of the total land area under forest. However, India aims at bringing 33% of its total land area under the forest cover. Now, we will understand what are the uses of forests, how forests are useful to us. As you all know, forests provide us many goods and services. To name a few, forests provide us fuel wood. As you all know, that in villages, people still rely on fuel wood as a means of cooking. Other than that, forests also provide us fodder for the cattle. Next is, forests have immense medicinal value. You must be knowing that different plants have medicinal properties and therefore are used in the manufacture of drugs and medicines, especially in the Ayurveda system of medicine. Not only this, forests are also helpful in maintaining the oxygen levels on the atmosphere. As you all know that forests and trees, they manufacture their food themselves by a process called photosynthesis. During photosynthesis, green plants inhale carbon dioxide and exhale oxygen, which is very important for the survival of living beings. Not only this, forests also help in reducing global warming to a great extent. Global warming happens due to increased levels of carbon dioxide and other gases in the atmosphere. Trees and forests, by inhaling carbon dioxide during photosynthesis, help to maintain its levels in the atmosphere, thereby reducing global warming. Not only this, forests help in prevention of dust storms and soil erosion. The roots of the trees keep the soil particles intact together, and help in prevention of soil top layer. Forests also help in regulating the water cycle on the planet, and they also provide us a number of products like edible oils, non-edible oils, spices, rubber, cotton, etc., etc. And obviously, forests are the natural homes for the wildlife. So these were some of the uses of forests. Now, moving ahead. As said earlier, the forest cover has been declining over the years, and it is mainly because of human intervention. Therefore, we could understand deforestation as an activity in which the forests are being cut down on a massive scale. It could be understood as the clearing of forest cover in order to accommodate agricultural, industrial, or urban use. And it has been happening all across the globe. Now, we will discuss some causes of deforestation. The first cause is agriculture or agricultural activities. As you all know that a growing population needs more food to consume. Therefore, in order to pave the way for agricultural lands, the farmers cut down the trees in order to sow crops and cereals, and this has come up as the single as the major cause of deforestation. Besides agriculture or farming, another cause of deforestation is logging. Logging is cutting down of trees and making logs, which are used in timber industry. Logging is also one of the main reasons behind deforestation. Next is urbanization. We are moving towards more developed economies. Therefore, we are taking up development projects on a large scale. Such projects include construction of roadways, highways, building dams, setting up industries, creating residential colonies, etc., etc. Such development projects are also causing deforestation on a large scale. Next is mining. In order to carry out mining, forests are cleared. Next is overgrazing. Overgrazing also results in loss of vegetation cover. And the next one is forest fires. Forest fires are quite common in Australia and California. Forest fires usually occur when the temperatures rise. These have also been a cause behind deforestation. However, most of the times, the forest fires occur naturally. Now, moving on further to the consequences of deforestation. Deforestation is threatening the existence of many wildlife species because forests are the natural homes for the wildlife. Therefore, the biodiversity is at loss due to destruction of forests. Next, it results in soil erosion. As said earlier, soil erosion happens when forests are not there because the roots of the trees keep the soil particles intact together. So, deforestation usually results in soil erosion. Next is, it also results in floods and droughts. because it disturbs the pattern of rainfall. And in hilly areas, it often leads to landslides. Not only this, deforestation is directly causing global warming and climate change, which has come up as one of the biggest environmental threats today. And it also causes or results noise pollution. So these were some of the consequences of deforestation. So that was the topic for today. Thank you.